Hello and welcome to Rise and Align. We are your hosts, Demi and
Haley,
and we talk about all things high vibrational and help you live a higher vibrational existence. Today, we're going to talk about what it means to be in alignment. What does alignment mean to you?
So to me, alignment means that you are doing things that are aligned with your path or that feels good, because when you feel good, I think that indicates that you are in alignment with what's meant for you.
Yep. I've always thought that too, that when you are in alignment, quote unquote, that it is a good feeling and that it means that you are aligned with your inner being or the source of all that is. But more recently, I've come to the conclusion that maybe we're always aligned. Maybe we're always on our path. Yeah.
Yes.
And I kind of think it might be this unconditional state of knowing of our well-being, even when we're feeling like these negative emotions, like whether you might feel fear, doubt, or worry, sadness, you know, we all experience that. Mm-hmm. But maybe we're still aligned when we're feeling those things. Like maybe we're meant to be feeling those things for the purpose of expansion, and that's just the path that we're on right now, you know?
Yes, I for sure agree with that. I also think, like, when we come into physical reality, we have the part of us that is source, connected to all things, and then our 3D persona.
Mm-hmm.
And it, of course, we're supposed to go through things. Also being able to have that inner knowing that everything's always working out and everything's going to be okay despite what's going on out here. You're able to kind of forget about and drown out what's going on out here and know that inside everything is exactly as it's meant to be.
Yeah, I totally agree. I think too, like, there was this plaque on someone's wall I read one time, and it was more so about like that unconditional state of knowing than necessarily like emotions are always flowing through us, right? Mm-hmm. Like waves of emotions are constant in physical reality. Like nobody is always happy, mm-hmm. you know? But I think that like understanding of, okay, well, this is what I'm going through right now, but I know that everything's going to work out. Mm-hmm. And that, like, even the concept or the belief that whatever awful thing is happening right now is going to bring me to the goal. Like, having mm-hmm. that belief, I swear it changes everything to, like, hold on to, okay, well, this is what I'm meant to experience right now. And, like, maybe what can I learn out of it, you know? Mm-hmm. And I think that when I see myself as being, like, out of alignment, it's when I'm not remembering that the universe has got me. It's mm-hmm. when I forget that I feel truly out of alignment.
Yes.
But, you know, it's not necessarily feeling negative emotion that makes me feel out of alignment. It's just the forgetting of our true being, our true existence,
yes.
You know?
Yes. Another important aspect to that is, like, finding, being present in the present moment, I feel like always brings you back into alignment. But also finding what is going to make you happiest in this moment, or finding like your highest excitement,
yes,
I think is so important here now. But also going off of what you said is like, you may not be exactly where you want to be or where you think you need to be, but, or the end goal, you're not going to be at your end goal, but finding what feels good or knowing that where you are right now
is always where you're meant to be.
Yes. But also, like, finding the joy on the journey. Like, what can make you happy now while you're going towards your goal?
Yeah.
Like, I think you can find small ways to feel in alignment with your purpose, even if you aren't,
quote unquote, there yet.
Yes. Because we're always.
Isn't it funny? It's funny because, like, we're only ever going to be here now, but ego always has this concept that there's somewhere to get to. Like, we're not there yet.
Yes.
We're not there yet. But what if we're already here?
And that's that's the balance of, like, the 3D human version of us,
yes,
and balancing that with the source that's also within us. Like,
yes,
the higher dimensional being that's within us.
Yes.
Like I said, we're human, we have egos, and we can get so caught up in how things should be. And we have all this programming that we have a hard time remembering like who or what we truly are. We're literally divine creators. Yes. And it can be easy to forget
that. The human ego is like in constant like no I'm what?
Oh my god.
It's so funny, but yeah, I think you know being present cuts through that. It cuts through anxiety, any negative emotion, really being present. Mm-hmm. We'll get rid of all of that. The irony in that is like the ego's like, we have somewhere to go. There's somewhere to go. Anxiety. And it's like, oh, if you're just here now, all of that goes away. And especially yes. if you intentionally focus on what feels good in the here now, mm-hmm. it'll change everything.
And it's hard to figure out or decide what feels good to you or what feels good in the moment or what you want to be doing when you have all of this other noise around you, like mm-hmm. what your family thinks or what society thinks you should be doing or what's right and what's wrong, because you start to forget like who you are inside, because we're being trained to
you should be doing this.
Yes, when like that none of that matters. So I just think it's so important to allow yourself to connect to that inner source, that inner being, that higher dimensional version of ourselves, because when you can do that, then I feel like that's when you're in alignment.
Yes, that's when you find true alignment. And I love how you said allow, mm-hmm. because that's what it is. It's an allowing. It's not a forceful chasing, trying to get to. It's an allowing.
Yes, that's what it is. Yes, that's something I wanted to talk about, is like what alignment feels like or what it may not feel like. And those are exactly it. Like it being in alignment feels good. It feels easy, I feel like ease is a better word than easy, yeah, but ease. Flowing and joyful. And like you can even tell when you're feeling. And like,
even just talking just like, about it
brings
the
me
way
in.
Yes, like the way that we even just like talking about it, you start to talk differently, you slow down. It's like it is ease. It's the opposite of anxious. It's more of a, it's less human, more being.
It is.
I think that it's a practice, you know. Mm-hmm. And I really think that we are fighting our own subconscious programming, mm-hmm. in so many ways to ironically just be and just remember who mm-hmm. we are, you know, because mm-hmm. it's always like we should be doing this, we should be going to work, we should be cleaning the house. Mm-hmm. I love
should
Abraham
be going
Hicks.
To college.
Yes, should. You should. There's so many things we should. One of my best friends says, "Stop shooting on yourself." But it's true, you know, like letting go and surrendering all of that, and just asking yourself what would feel the best in this moment to do, you yes. know, and that when you follow that highest excitement, I truly believe that you align to the highest vibration. How you feel, your feelings are the conscious awareness of the frequency at which you're vibrating at. That's what we're acting out of, and that's what's creating our reality, right? Mm-hmm. So when we follow our highest excitement and we align to those higher vibrational feelings, we automatically attract higher vibrational experiences into our reality. And it's so funny because all you have to do is surrender. All you have to do is let yes. go of the should, mm-hmm. and the fear, anxiety, don't worry, and just be.
Yes. And the emotions are an indicator if we are on the right path or if we yeah. are in alignment. So if you're feeling good, mm-hmm. that's the point. That's what you're meant to be doing. But I feel like emotions can be a really good indicator. Like if you start feeling negative, you start feeling like lack, or you start feeling anything that makes you feel bad, that's not in alignment.
I've used that exact words to tell so many of my clients, okay, when you're having a negative emotion, use it as a trigger to ask yourself what you're thinking, what your human ego is thinking about the circumstances that you're experiencing right now that is different from that of what source would say.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of times, like, humans have emotions about money and love. That's pretty much it, you know, when it comes down to it.
Food.
Yeah. And so, like, if you're feeling, like, sad that, say, somebody rejected you, what would source say? You know, like, what would the universe think about that? Mm-hmm. And it's always, well, source created you,
mm-hmm.
and you are unconditional love. It doesn't matter if somebody else aligns with you or not, mm-hmm. it doesn't change your value, yeah. you know? And so asking yourself, okay, so what is differing in my thoughts and opinions and beliefs about whatever is happening right now than that of what source might say or think or believe about you truly? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And that's your true essence, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
That's the truth.
Yes. Like, it can be hard for people to focus on the more positive perspective mm-hmm. of a situation like that because mm-hmm. they're going to want to blame themselves or feel like something's wrong with them. But like you said, you have to shift your perspective into what source would believe about you, which you mm-hmm. are source. So you, by shifting, it's a practice. I think you had said that earlier, like it's a practice. You have to practice thinking about what source would think in mm-hmm. a way. Like you yeah. have to start.
Well, it's literally reprogramming your subconscious because mm-hmm. it's natural for us to believe whatever we were taught growing up from mm-hmm. the ages of when we were born until we were about 7 or 8 years old. We're literally taught what to believe. And that's what we act out of for the rest of our life unless we intentionally change that. Mm-hmm. So the only way to do that is by repetition of the right ideas. And also I've found actual physical action. So I know you and I practice so many different things that, you know, help us become aligned. And there are certain things that I can do at any moment, any time. It doesn't matter what is going on in my physical reality that will bring me into alignment. And I know that. And I literally have lists of things like, okay, you're going to choose one of these things and you're going to take action, because when you do that, you teach your mind what to value. Mm-hmm. So instead of allowing this program to go on and on and on, and so many people tell me they feel stuck. Mm-hmm. So in order to get unstuck, you have to take physical action mm-hmm. to show your brain what you value. And as you do that as a practice, mm-hmm. when you intentionally take that action, then you reprogram your subconscious mind. And then you start to habitually do things that you value, and your whole life changes, really.
So what are some of these things that you have on your list that you like to do to bring you back into alignment?
Well, number one, yoga.
Yes.
So I know Haley is a certified yoga instructor, and mm-hmm. we've talked about it before. Yoga has changed our lives.
Yeah,
and
we'll definitely do an episode on that.
Definitely,
too.
Definitely. You know, I've been doing it every day, and the reason that I start my day with that is because it makes me feel so aligned. It makes me feel so good. And when you start your day feeling that way, you act out of that, and it creates better days, better mm-hmm. weeks, better months, better lives.
Yes. Just to build off of that, when you're practicing yoga, and I feel like yoga has such a stereotype built upon it these days. It's actually very different than I think a lot of people view it. Anyone can do yoga. Everyone can do yoga. But yoga is very healing to our nervous system. Mm-hmm. If we are, a lot of us in society today are in a constant fight or flight state. When you are in this fight or flight state, you're in that very like scarcity, lack, worry mindset. And if you can't pull yourself out of that, how are you ever going to feel in alignment? So yoga is such a great practice to calm your nervous system and allow yourself to get grounded in your body and start maybe getting connected to your feelings, because some people are so disconnected to even their feelings. Yoga is such a great way to heal the nervous system and allow yourself to connect back inwards, because it's also going to help you connect to your intuition, which I think is another great way to
be aligned. Yeah. Yes. Oh my god, so yeah, we're gonna do a whole episode on yoga. There are so many things I could say. Some of the other things that I will intentionally do, and it's gonna sound funny, is literally just practicing presence. So like, if I'm going to make myself a latte and enjoy it, I'm going to sit and enjoy my latte. I'm gonna especially put my phone down. What mm-hmm. a practice. Mm-hmm. And yes. another thing that I've done is I plug my phone in somewhere else besides my bedroom at night, and I don't look at it for like an hour in the morning. Mm-hmm. And whenever I stop doing this practice, I can tell my anxiety is way worse.
Yes. And it can be so hard. So I've started recently to not pick up and start scrolling right mm-hmm. away. And we've trained ourselves to do that. So I've found that it's so hard. But I have noticed a major difference because when you pick up that phone and start scrolling right away, you are taking in other people's energy, mm-hmm. you're taking in their perspective instead yep. of grounding yourself in your own perspective to start off the day. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if you have a ritual or a practice in place that allows you to feel aligned, if you can do that before you start interacting on social media and before you're going out in the world and participating in life, like, that's it'll how you stay aligned. Life. That's how you can yeah. go throughout your day, staying aligned, because yep. you connect inwards first.
Yes. Yeah.
Just so important.
And I feel like when you have that, when you we become grounded in those practices, you start to be more aware of your well-being unconditionally, truly. Because mm-hmm. mm-hmm. When you're really connected, things will still happen. Like, contrast is inevitable. It is half the purpose of us being here, you know? Like, mm-hmm. we need the contrast to expand. But when you really find those practices and find that grounding within yourself, then you become so much more connected to, okay, this sucks right now, mm-hmm. but it's going to be okay.
Yes, and you can kind of look at it with a new appreciation of, like, I know this is serving me for my highest good. I know that I'm going to expand from this. I'm going to grow from this. Like, yeah. what's the point if we aren't growing and expanding?
Mm-hmm. It changes your perspective so much. Mm-hmm. And also on the phone thing, not only are you taking in so much of other people's energy and what they're posting, and I find that the majority of what a lot of people post, or even just like emails, is like news, and it's constant negativity. Mm-hmm. But it's not even just that. It's that we are addicted to the dopamine hits that our phone gives us. Mm-hmm. So when you do that first thing in the morning, you're teaching your brain to value that. Mm-hmm. And then that's what you're valuing and depending on for dopamine mm-hmm. all day, every day. Mm-hmm. And I think that so many people are caught in that trap right now. And I'm just as guilty of it. Yes. Yes. But yeah, what a game changer to stop looking at your phone first thing in the morning. It will change your life. Mm-hmm. Some other things, I know you are like me on this, going for walks. We yes. need those hot girl walks. Yes, because yes, I swear. Yes.
In nature. Like,
in nature, yes. yes. Mm-hmm. Where it's quiet. I think we're so blessed to live in such a beautiful place where mm-hmm. we can go out and not see a bunch of people. Mm-hmm. You know, which maybe I need to work on my social anxiety skills. But I really love to be alone in nature. It really helps you connect. And for me, it kind of reminds me that I am truly connected to all that is, you know, mm-hmm. and it's you, I think because we're so stuck on technology nowadays, like we've grown up with it, it's so rare that we listen to our thoughts.
Mm-hmm. It's so true.
That we are mm-hmm. actually quiet, or that we even, you know, I've learned so much about auto-suggestion, which is talking to yourself. Mm-hmm. It's so rare that people take the time to hang out with themselves. Mm-hmm. Yes. and going outside into nature really allows you to tap into those thoughts and just see what comes up. Like, it mm-hmm. is definitely a meditation in mm-hmm. ways, which meditation is another huge way yes. to get into alignment. Tell me what you think about meditation.
I'm gonna just go off on the outdoors thing first, like yep. walking in nature. It's very grounding also. So when you're taking in all of this stimulus throughout your day, like, that's overwhelming to your nervous system. So again, that's another thing that's going to get you out of that fight or flight state and allow your nervous system to relax. And you can also, like, you can start connecting, you can start hearing those thoughts that come up. And nature in itself is so healing. So I just think that's a really important, great way to help yourself get back into alignment. Meditation, I think, is the ultimate way to get back into alignment. It allows you to connect or be one with source energy. Mm-hmm. I also think that meditation allows us, again, to drown out the noise, mm-hmm. to connect inwards. And it's really when people say, like, oh, like, I'm not the meditating type, or like, I can't meditate. I have too many thoughts. The people who feel like they can't meditate are the ones that need it the most.
Yeah.
But I just think that meditating is the most healing practice.
I think so many people would agree with that too. And I think the highest vibrational people would agree with that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And I was asking you what you thought about it because of that same concept, and it's similar to yoga, mm-hmm. that people will say, I just can't do that. I mm-hmm. just can't focus. You can.
And it is hard. That's why we're being in alignment is like retraining all of these bad yep. habits and programming. Like, yes, it's hard.
It feels hard. And yes. I think it's because we're expecting something specific out of it. I think it's mm-hmm. because we're battling with ego. But the thing that I've learned in my meditation practice, it's a practice, and I mm-hmm. could definitely do some work on it, mm-hmm. if I'm being mm-hmm. honest, you know. But there were times where I was like, I'm never doing this again. It's so annoying. And I can't, mm-hmm. my brain, my whatever's talking up there, she never shuts up. You know, but the thing is, like, you don't necessarily have to make your mind be silent. You just have to be present to listen. Mm-hmm. And it's not, you can't do it wrong.
Right. And so you have this voice in your head, and, you know, that's talking, but you also have the observer. Mm-hmm. I almost think of it as like two different parts in my brain. Yes. It's like you also have the observer that's observing your thoughts. And meditation allows you to tap into being the observer. So you can start to listen to these thoughts that you're having. And, you know, if they are more negative, then you know that you're thinking these negative things, and you can start to
take opposite action.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And start to find alignment. Mm-hmm. But when you're meditating and you can be in this observer role, you can also witness these thoughts coming through, and you can say, okay, I see you, and move on. Like, you can acknowledge it and let it go. Like,
yep.
move on. And I think that helps you not become so fixated on it when you acknowledge it.
Mm-hmm. No, and to learn to not internalize it. Because mm-hmm. when we do, and we allow our minds to get caught up in focusing on whatever negative situation might be going on, we're always outside of the present moment. Mm-hmm. I swear, always. Fear, don't worry are never about the now. They're always mm-hmm. about the future or past. Mm-hmm. And I love that you said the observer, because I think that meditation in a huge way has taught me to be the observer of my reality and mm-hmm. kind of detach from, you know, like, before I used to think like, these negative emotions are going to kill me. Like, it was like, you know, it can be so painful, and even it can create pain and manifest mm-hmm. dis-ease within your body, you know. Mm-hmm. But to learn to detach and say, okay, I can observe this, mm-hmm. and I can also ask myself, or maybe even ask the source within me, mm-hmm. what is your perspective on this? Mm-hmm. You know, what might be, when I zoom out, you know, like, this boy hurt my feelings right now and it hurts so bad. But in the scheme of things, maybe it's a blessing, mm-hmm. you know, like mm-hmm. when you zoom out, okay, well, this sucks right now, but I've made it through every other thing that sucked.
It's true. And also, like, then you can tell yourself, like, it wasn't meant to be, and something better is coming. Mm-hmm. Like, that's what Source wants you to hear. They mm-hmm. want something better is coming for you. So, like, becoming fixated on this said thought or feeling or emotion can block the blessings. Like, you yep. can block the infinite abundance from flowing in and from welcoming, like, the experiences that feel good.
Literally. Yeah. And I think that meditation, you know, it's so key to allowing in the blessings. Mm-hmm. It really connects you to the present moment, mm-hmm. and all that is here now, mm-hmm. you know.
And I think people find meditation intimidating, and I think they are kind of fearful of it, because then you're kind of forced to look at your thoughts. The ultimate goal from meditation, especially from like a yoga perspective, is enlightenment. Mm-hmm. And that is becoming one with Source. Mm-hmm. That is detaching from everything in your physical reality. It is not, you're letting all of that dissolve. You are one with Source. And that might feel scary, because it's people like don't want to let go of
yes.
what's out here.
Yes. Yes. It's like you have to let go of everything that ego identifies as you.
Mm-hmm. It is. Yes.
Eckhart Tolle, he talks about that, I believe, in A New Earth, about what the ego identifies as you. And when you really start to think about it, you realize that none of that is you. Mm-hmm. and I agree with you. In meditation, you literally have to learn detachment and letting go of all of the physical concepts and constructs that you believe to be you and your reality, mm-hmm. and just connect to all that is. Mm-hmm. And it can be so intimidating. I think for me, what really changed my perspective on meditation, and it literally took me years, was that what if you look at it as a relaxation? Like, what if you look at it as, if you've ever gotten a massage, you go to get a massage and you're kind of excited about like this time, or you get your nails done or whatever. Mm-hmm. You're not like stressed out, like, I have to do this, mm-hmm. and I have to feel a certain way when I do this.
Yeah.
You just let go and allow yourself, yes. to feel good.
Yes.
That's what meditation is like. And I remember when I was a kid and I used to sit in the backseat of the car. When you're a kid and you've never driven before, you don't really worry about who's driving you, mm-hmm. especially if you're like on a highway and a long trip, mm-hmm. like you just trust that it's fine.
Yeah.
And you don't think about like, what do I need to do to make this right? Mm-hmm. You just relax. And like, that's how kids end up napping in the back of the car.
Mm-hmm.
For me, that is the feeling that I want to reach, mm-hmm. when in meditation. I don't, mm-hmm. necessarily want to stop my mind from working or sit up super straight, or, you know, it's, mm-hmm. not like I have to do anything.
Mm-hmm.
The only thing I want, desire, is allow and, yeah. being. Yeah, yeah, being, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. just relaxing into the now.
Mm-hmm. And I think there are other ways of meditating than just the traditional, like, sit down, close your eyes. Mm-hmm. I've heard a lot of people have success with, like, dancing, like meditation, like you can kind of get to this state when you're dancing, or I've heard if you're painting, like if you're an artist, like, mm-hmm. doing something creative, I feel like, is a really great way to kind of help become or connect to this like meditative state, or, mm-hmm. this allowing state, because when you're being creative, like, you're letting source energy flow through you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You're not resisting, you're just allowing life to flow through you and create, which source energy, I think, is creation. Like,
yeah, I think even just being present is a meditation in a way, you know. Like, I was gonna say, I've read a book talking about how when you're walking in the woods, you can walk really slowly and become really present and take a breath each step you take. Breath work is another amazing, mm-hmm. way to get into,
yes.
alignment.
Yes. Yes.
And yoga is moving meditation for me. I think, yes. yoga taught me how to meditate.
Yes, me too. And I feel like yoga kind of encompasses breath work and meditation and movement all, mm-hmm. in one, which I think is
perfect. It's so good. Yeah. It's so good. It's so good.
And yeah, like with yoga, it's like you accidentally meditate. Like, it's, yes. like you don't mean to, but you do, because, yes. you have to get lost in the present moment, like in, mm-hmm. in the here now, mm-hmm. to and be fully present with each pose so you don't fall over. So, you know, it's just like naturally
forces you to be, yeah. present. It really does. Well, and it's really interesting because our subconscious mind is what controls our emotions, mm-hmm. and our physical body.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, it is possible to use your conscious mind to impact your subconscious mind.
Mm-hmm.
It's also possible to use your physical body to impact your subconscious mind. It works both ways, and that's, mm-hmm. something that yoga has really taught me. And, mm-hmm. you know, you were saying people are a lot of times not in tune with their emotions or their feelings.
Mm-hmm.
I was not in tune with my physical feeling, mm-hmm. body, mm-hmm. and yes. your physical body stores your emotions,
yep.
so we're gonna have to come back to this in, yeah. our yoga episode, come back, oh, for that, maybe, yes. that'll be our next episode, because, yes. can't wait to talk about it. But yeah, some other ways that I love to get into alignment, they're all ways of becoming present, but, mm-hmm. to journal.
Yep.
I love to do tarot. I feel like most tarot cards have so many good positive perspective and, mm-hmm. questions to make you think about, like, okay, what am I focusing on, feeling, believing, and acting out of, you, mm-hmm. know?
Yep.
Books. Oh, I love to read books.
Yes. Yes.
And listening to podcasts, mm-hmm. or, you know, talks on YouTube that, yep. are, I know that they're high vibration. I know that what they're talking about is going to help me expand in, mm-hmm. some way.
Mm-hmm.
I'll listen to it all day.
Yes. Yes. that is the same for me. It's like taking in high vibrational media, meditation. My favorite way to get in alignment is having like a morning ritual. So I have set time for myself every morning, whether say it's like half an hour, I make my coffee and I sit, and then depending on how I'm feeling that day, I kind of let myself do what feels good in that time. So a lot of times I'll just sit there and presently drink my coffee, but sometimes I find some stretches, or I do a little bit of yoga, or I read, and it all just kind of depends on what I'm feeling like that day, like what I feel like I need the most. But schedule time for me to get grounded and connect so that I feel in alignment. Like that's just like so necessary for me to show up and feel like my highest self every day.
I love that you said that I just schedule this time and I don't force myself to do anything specific.
Mm-hmm.
Because for me, I think when I first started to really try to change my physical reality and, you know, change my mental state,
mm-hmm.
I was very about like, I have to do yoga
mm-hmm.
every single morning
mm-hmm.
for at least an hour.
Mm-hmm.
And at first I'm going to do this, and then after I'm going to do that. And I was mm-hmm. like super caught on schedules, and like I have to wake up at 5 a.m. every single day.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm like, you know, sometimes it's nice to wake up,
mm-hmm. yes.
but the flow to allow myself to do what feels best.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Yes. Yes.
Mm. It's everything.
Yes. The same. Recently, I have been sleeping in
mm-hmm.
because that's just what I feel like I need. And like sometimes your ego gets in the way and you're like, no, you have to get up at this time. Like you're being lazy.
It's like
you're
not shaming.
But
yes.
it's like, no, like it, like allowing yourself to do what feels good and not feeling guilty about it.
Mm-hmm.
Like that's okay.
Do you know what? I am just as valuable if I get up at 9:30.
Yes, like it's okay as long as it feels good to you.
Yeah.
But if you're waking up and you're like in a really negative mind space because you've slept in and now you're stressed out because you don't have enough time to get ready for work, like
mm-hmm.
that's not being in alignment. But
yeah.
if you wake up and you're feeling good and you're excited about your day, like that's okay. I think that
yeah
it's just a matter of like, again, feeling, doing what feels good. And
I think, you know, unlearning self-shaming,
mm-hmm.
it's so big.
Mm-hmm.
It's been really big for me because mm-hmm. I was very like always judging myself, like you need to do this or mm-hmm. you're not good enough,
mm-hmm.
you're not even gonna make it.
Isn't that crazy, our egos? I tell ya.
Yeah And I think, you know, what it all comes down to is just being here now,
mm-hmm.
just allowing
mm-hmm.
yep. and aligning.
Yes. And I think just one thing I want to add on is when you wake up in the morning and you feel resistance towards your job or towards something, like I think that's a sign that thing is like no longer what's meant for you. Like, when you start noticing the things that make you feel bad, like start eliminating those from your experience. Like I've had situations where I would wake up in the morning and really hate the job that I worked at, or mm-hmm. I couldn't, when you're starting off your day in such a negative state, like how are you ever going to be connected to your soul's path or what source wants from you if you continue to perpetuate a life that feels out of alignment or negative?
Yeah,
so
and forcing yourself mm-hmm. to do that.
And I've kind of taught myself it might be scary to make the leap to quit your job, but once you do, something better always comes.
Mm-hmm.
And now I've learned, like I've noticed those little breadcrumbs right away. There was one morning I woke up and I was like, I don't really want to do this today. I don't want to go to work today. Like I don't want this. And I immediately knew that it's not meant for me anymore. I've what I was meant to learn there, I've learned, and it's time for me to move on to my next adventure. And I think, again, going back to alignment being a practice, like once you practice being in alignment, it becomes easier to know when you're out of it.
Oh my gosh.
So it's like instantaneously, like I knew.
I think you become braver too. Like the more, and Bob Proctor was my mentor, and he always said, the more you study, the more you will, it'll be habitual for you to, you know, go off of this faith, because you can't work on blind faith. But when you come into the understanding that how you feel matters more than anything, and at the end of the day, the only reason that anybody wants anything is because they feel, they believe that they will feel better in the having of it. So, you know, when you do that, when you realize that and you really study, like, okay, how I feel is my frequency, my energy. Well, if this job is making me feel stressed out every day, for me, I'm a quitter. I quit every job because I'm like, I don't want to do this anymore. I don't like it anymore. It's stressing me out now. As soon as I get to that point, I'm like, nah, I'm quitting. And people be like, you're crazy. Like last time I just bought a house on a car, and people are like, what are you gonna, how are you gonna pay your bills? I'm like, I don't know. I don't know. I don't care.
Everything always works out for us.
And that's what I said. You know, I just, what I do know is that I can't feel like this anymore. I'd rather be broke.
And that is being in alignment, trusting.
Yes.
Trusting, even when it's scary or you don't see a way out or you don't know how it's going to work out, let the universe do that for you. Like, you just have to, like, allow it.
Yes.
You have to be in a state where you can allow it. Faith. Like, welcome it in. If you're resisting it, it's never going to flow to you.
So. Yes. If you quit your job and you say, okay, well, now I'm going to be homeless, and you just stay in those negative feelings, that's going to happen. But if you quit your job and you say, you know what, I know this relief is going to attract something so much better for me, then it will. And for me, like, it was, do I believe? Show me how good it can get. Show me how good it can get. Yes.
I dare you.
Yes. Yes. For me, it was, do I believe in myself enough to just trust what the universe is telling me right now? And when I said yes, the universe said, here you go, it's gonna be okay.
Yes,
always works out. It always works out. Everything is always working out for us,
always.
Well, on that note, thanks so much for listening, and
yes, we really appreciate anyone or everyone who's listening. We're really excited to go on this journey. We're just, we want to have fun together and raise the vibration and talk about things that matter and that are exciting and high vibrational and allow us to heal.
Yeah. And also thank you for listening, because in doing so, not only are you hopefully feeling better and therefore raising your own frequency, but actually raising the frequency of the planet, because energy is contagious. Yes. And it does really spread and snowball to every person that you come in contact with. So it's our goal here to help raise the frequency of the planet as much as possible. And
yes,
we love you.
We do. We love you. Thank you.
So we'll see you in our next episode about yoga.